You're gonna love this.
The Senate Ethics Committee is launching a full-scale investigation into the black sites and Senator Lord's cover-up.
Is that exclusive?
No. Cohen's office put out a press release. You want me to press him for a quote that nails Dorian?
No. I already have one.
Oh, tell me what you think. Solange did a great job. I've got Michelle's bangs, Pelosi's lips.
It's great.
How bad is it?
We gotta cancel the interview.
Look, it's not that bad. I promise. You know what? We're just going to, we'll go to Plan B.
Does Plan B include me and a noose?
No, it includes you and me, and we go on a nice long vacation somewhere warm. Away from cell phones, away from Wi-Fi. We can drink out of coconuts, you can rub suntan lotion on me. We leave the politics to the sharks.
Yeah. Senate Ethics Committee to investigate Dorian Lord alleged cover-up. Well, screw them all!
This is expensive.
Let me tell you something. The junior senator from Pennsylvania is not going down without a fight.
In a desperate attempt to please party goers, VIP hostess throws herself at clock goers?
The reporter was probably just jealous you weren't throwing yourself at him.
I'd rather not.
stop. Stop pressing. Let me be.
The blogs are gonna go nuts. The American public are a bunch of idiots who can't be trusted to spell their own names.
Okay, you cannot print that. Well, not without confirmation.
Well, she said it to you, right?
Yes, she did, but
then
there were other...
This is huge. Dorian buried those flight manifests for months.
Not according to her. She claims she gave it to Conan Ashford immediately.
Who cares? Somebody sat on it, okay? The point is, are there black sites or not? And now, we've got these guys by the balls.
In what sense?
They have to investigate. And our story made that happen.
But is it right for us to make Dorian collateral damage?
Don't get soft on me, boss.
Oh, Jeffrey, wait a minute. This is a very big story, and I have to make sure that we are above reproach. So just as you had to confirm the manifest sources...
A U.S. senator squashes information about illegal torture sites and then calls Americans morons for not understanding the way things really work, and you want to let that slide?
Now, wait a minute. She said that to me, referring to the readers of my newspaper. If I print it, it looks like a personal vendetta.
You hired me to help you bring the banner into the digital age.
But that does not mean abandoning journalistic ethics.
It is a whole new world. It is every man and woman for herself. Do you know how hard it is to nail down one detail that has been published 5 minutes ago on some blog in India, and you're asking me to hold this?
No. No, I am telling you, confirm the quote.
Hello, Senator Lord. I would like to get your sign off on calling the American people a bunch of idiots that...
I get it, okay? Get off my desk.
Do you want to save our paper or not?
Don't you get smart with me.
Then there should be no question. We run with this. Boss.
So my PR peeps say I've only got one big problem. And that is... the decision who to give the exclusive to.
I would like to officially go on record as saying that I think this idea stinks. Throw that back.
No, thank you. David, you thought it was a very good idea to go on TV yesterday.
That was before Senator Cohn threw you under the bus and launched an investigation by the Ethics Committee.
And that's exactly why I can't back down now. I'd look guilty as sin.
If the U.S. government is still running black sites, somebody's going down.
Well, it is not going to be me. If those two ancient hypocrites... Wait a minute. Wait a minute. You know, maybe Vicky has done me a favor.
You're gonna have to explain that one to me.
I am going to be a whistleblowing Shiro.
Shiro I like, but Conan Ashford are never gonna let that happen.
They're not gonna have any choice, David.
Dorian, you're... venerable senior senators have officially screwed you, so no matter what you say, it's going to be your word against theirs, and there's no way you can win that battle.
I did nothing wrong!
Yeah, you did, baby. You trusted them. For the first time in her life, Dorian Lord committed the crime of being naive.
I committed the crime of wanting to serve my country, and how dare you attack me instead of supporting me, David?
Listen to me. You're going to resign today because I'm sick and tired of watching those sharks eat you alive. Oh. Hello? Hold on a moment. A reporter wants to do an interview today from the home of Senator Dorian Lord, where she has apparently holed herself up, avoiding the press.
Oh, I've holed myself up and I'm avoiding the press. Did they just say that?
I'm going to tell them we're not interested. Thank you for the opportunity.
Hello, this is Senator Dorian Lord. What time is the crew going to get here?
Hey, Cutter. This officer needs to talk to you. What happened? What's going on?
Oh, just make yourself at home there. That's okay, it's a little early for me.
Thought we could hang out. You know, man to man.
What
do you think you're doing?
You two have a great time catching up.
This?
A nursery.
Yeah, I see that.
I didn't know how to tell you.
Tell me what?
We had a baby. Our baby.
Yours and mine?
Yeah. Yeah. Victor Jr.
Where is he?
He's nowhere. Our baby died.
So, officer, what's up? Gotcha, man. He's on our side.
What? I don't get it.
Relax, man. No one's arresting you.
So what are you here for?
He's my man. Bruce Hunter? Meet Cutter.
Dean filled me in on your situation.
I still don't understand.
Dean said you need some help.
Help?
Listen, by day, Bruce wears the uniform. By night, he is our security officer.
Okay. I think I'm starting to understand. But look, okay, I don't want to know any of the details.
Cool.
So you're paid to get men drunk?
Oh, my God, Vimal, please.
I'm just trying to understand.
This is the reason I moved out.
I'm not judging.
Oh my gosh, you're always judging. What I wear, who I'm hanging out with, what I do. Why don't you just stay in India? You should just find yourself a nice traditional Indian girl.
But I don't want a nice traditional Indian girl. I want you.
Thanks, I think. Stop staring and you mind your business.
Rama, I love you. I tried to forget you when I was out traveling, but I can't get you out of my head or my heart.
Me neither.
So?
I love you, but it's not gonna work. I'm not ready.
For what?
I'm not ready to be with one man for the rest of my life. Listen, we tried, okay? I failed. I don't want to betray you again.
We love each other. So what's the problem?
That's the problem, Mama. We love each other, but we met when we were too young. Okay, we haven't lived life. I want to live life. In 10 or 20 years from now, I'm gonna wonder, you're gonna wonder, and if we don't do it now and we don't know now, then we're gonna cheat on each other then, we'll betray each other and break each other's hearts, and I don't wanna do that.
So, let me get this straight. You wanna sleep with other guys now, so that you won't cheat on me 20 years from now, and that's why we can't be together.
Exactly.
Senator Lord, what did you know, and when did you know it?
Well, Bethany, as I was saying, thank you so much.
Can we do anything about the overhead lights? It's a little unforgiving.
Oh, thank you, David. That's so sweet of you. But, darling, couldn't you stay in character, okay?
Oh, right. I'm Bethany. Where were we?
Oh, me. Bethany, I would just like the American public to know that I did the right thing. I turned over those flight manifests as soon as I saw the implication of them.
But Senator Cohn says that you're a liar, liar, pants on fire.
David, please, would you take this seriously?
I am taking this seriously.
Never mind, we do. No more practicing. I don't need to rehearse. I'm telling the truth, okay? The public can always tell when somebody is lying and when they're telling the truth.
All right, everybody.
Oh, quick. Just check me.
And we're live in 10.
Oh, 10. Oh, there she is, Bethany. Love your work, dear. Yes.
Sorry, got here as soon as I could.
Oh, Clint, that might be a bit premature.
Vicky, I'm an optimist.
Well, look, she's on.
This is gonna be epic.
Do you think you could just blow back into town and slide back into your son's life, Todd? You are the most selfish son of a bitch. You think that you can do whatever you want, and there are no consequences. You shoot your own brother. You leave him for dead. I mean, Victor practically raised your kids. You framed Tomas, and you get away with it. Wonder why that is, huh? Oh, I know. Because you're Todd Manning, right?
Blair.
No, don't Blair me. No, I'm... No more, because you're incapable of telling the truth anyway. Got me to believe in you, and I bought it. I really did. Again and again. I mean, you get away with murder.
You're what?
Stop! You! You get away with murder, and then you go off. You leave this town. You leave the family that you say that you love so much. You ride in here on your big white horse like a knight in shining armor to save Danny. And you think a beer with Pop is just gonna fix everything? Really? Not anymore, Todd.
I went into labor. I couldn't get to the hospital. It was raining. It was storming out. We were driving.
Who's we?
Todd was driving.
Go on.
Todd delivered our baby. I never heard him make a sound. Victor Jr., I never heard him make a sound. I knew something was wrong. I knew it. Todd left me to go to the hospital with Victor Jr. And when I saw Todd, he had our beautiful baby boy. I was so relieved. I was so happy. Our baby was alive. Only it wasn't our baby. Our baby had died. Todd switched the babies. And when I found out...
Senator Cohn insists they never received any evidence from you regarding the existence of black sites. Do you have any proof, or is this just a case of he said, she said?
Bethany, I just want the American public to understand that my only crime was in trusting that Chairman Cohn and Vice Chairman Ashford would do the right thing with the documents, which I handed over to them immediately. Now, it's up to the American public to judge for themselves.
It's interesting you say that, because this quote from you has gone viral just since we've been on the air. Now, according to the banner online, you called the American public, and I quote, a bunch of idiots who can't be trusted to spell their own names right.
It's a little early for a nightclub.
I told Cutter I would help him set up. Last time was a disaster.
Cutter. Cool.
Where are you staying?
I was hoping with you.
Himmel.
Just until I get myself settled again.
That is not a good idea.
You afraid you can't resist me?
Maybe.
So don't.
Himmel. I'm sorry. I hate this.
There has to be a way we can make this work.
I have no idea how, unless you would consider an open marriage.
Right. You mean, like you could be with other guys, but still be with me?
Yeah, and that would drive you insane.
Maybe.
You'd actually let me date other guys?
I don't know. If that's what it takes.
You love me that much?
I want to be with you. now, not in 10 or 20 years.
And you wouldn't get jealous?
Well, I'd get to date other women.
Would you?
Well, that's what an open marriage is.
And what would your parents say?
They wouldn't have to know.
Are you serious?
Well, we would have to lay some ground rules.
Don't ask, don't tell.
And we always come home to each other. You see, if I can have that, I can put up with anything. I missed you.
Did you hear that?
Yes, yes.
Oh, dear, I almost feel sorry for Dorian.
Boss.
What? I said almost.
I think this calls for a celebration. Whoa.
All right, everybody, that's a wrap. Good job. Let's, everybody just head out for a bit. We'll get the equipment in a minute. Just head on out. Thank you very much. Leo, head out. You know what? Maybe he didn't play the way that it... Like you said, the American people are... Who cares what the American people are? What matters is you. You spoke up. You didn't go down without a fight. You know what? You stood up. And you fell down. Pretty hard. But I think what's important, you know, there's a saying that goes, I need a drink. Do you want a drink? I'm gonna make us something special in the kitchen.
The key you are going to pay.
You know you're hot when you're angry.
Why don't you do us all a favor? And get back on that private jet. And go back to Port Charles. Because you're useless as a husband and a lover, and you're even more pathetic as a father. Look at that. Todd Manning was speechless.
There's nothing to say if it's true.
Listen, I didn't want to burden you with any of this. Not after what you've been through. You know that together we can get past whatever it is. You know that, right?
I'm worried about you and Todd. It's not going to help
Todd
you.
Todd is part of our past, but he's not going to be part of our future, all right? I think you should go to the hospital and check on Danny.
Well, she was sleeping when we left.
Just humor me.
Okay. Are you coming?
Yeah, in a minute.